drunk as fuck, dude.
Last time on Set It Off Atlanta.
Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, I'm done.
Guys, this is season two of Combo with Friends.
People from the group. It won't be people from the group. It'll be people from our from that.
And Norris is making up a damn event. He gave us canned drinks. There was no fountain machine. Canned drinks.
How come all my business and it's on his law? That's some of your information.
It was nice to see everybody.
Who the boss, bitch?
Who they mad at?
Who the bad bitch? I told you who the bad bitch. Pop the champagne, I'm that nigga. Blow up your spot, hoe, take six figures. Yeah. Sex good, girl, how you figure? A rock star can't take your nigga. Right. A bad bitch, here I came with a plan. And I air this bitch out with my dick in my hand. Yeah. With your nigga screaming out in the stands. No need to be cocky if your bitch is a fan. Yeah. Listen, babe, I get shit popping just right. The flyest nigga walking, keep bread, catch flights. Party all night, rock the bitch just right. Knocking hating ass bitches out on sight. Let it be known, homie, stay in your lane. Cause you know little daddy came to hit with the pain. And remember, if we doing this for fame, put your cash on K-Star, stop fucking with lames.
Who the boss, bitch? Who on that fly shit? Who got the switch, bitch? Yeah. I told you that I came to set it off. I'ma take the game by the neck at any cost. Wanna talk slick trick, bitch, get tossed. You a bum, bitch.
I love it. Y'all know the fuck going on. It's BLAQ off in this bitch, period. We at Blaq Ink Atlanta, in downtown Atlanta. This Buckhead, ain't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, we in Buckhead. That's what we are. We in downtown Atlanta. We doing it. Y'all just watch. Stay tuned. It's about to be a whole movie out this bitch. Y'all know the fuck on us. BLAQ, period. Yeah.
The day is here. It is New Year's Eve, and your boy is about to perform for BET. Y'all, I am at Blaq Ink Atlanta, and I'm so excited.
You want to go see the stage? Okay. Let's go see your stage.
I'll be back.
So regardless of the fact that, you know, me and Norris had this issue, you know, prior to this event or whatever like that, he was still considered my assistant. So I invited him out, some people, other people, some of my friends, you know, I got my dancers together, like, we about to do the damn thing.
Okay, so it's going
to be here at 6.
Okay. I got you. And so who's going to use it?
You know what I mean? No, I'm just like saying.
He's setting it up.
Okay. Appreciate it, boss. Cash, this ain't no code, bitch. Get the fuck out of
here. They ain't even got the cool. Still the So I'm here, and I'm telling my assistant, Norris, like, bro, go find out what's going on, what we're supposed to do, whatever, like this and third. Because, mind you, I think thinking that's what an assistant is supposed to do. I'm not supposed to be asking any questions. I'm not supposed to be wondering what's going on or none of that stuff. They're supposed to be handling all that for me. I shouldn't have to tell you things. Like, if you want to say that you're a celebrity, whatever, and you are wanting to, you got clients and all this stuff like that, I'm sure these clients have told you how to do certain things. And when it comes to little old me, I'm very professional when it comes down to my business. So, bro, if you're going to be all over the place and not telling me what's going on, you fucking up my vibe. I don't need to be around you at this point. You don't need to be my assistant at this point. Like, what's going on?
Do what you do. Feeling froggy, gonna make that ass jump when you see it represent a real nigga from the dark.
Dope in there. I mean, I done several interviews. You know, a big nigga like me, I walk off in the room, they're trying to figure out who I am. I had my whole team with me, cameras everywhere. They're asking to do interviews. My performance was dope. Honestly, I felt like it was the best performance of the night, and I was like the first performance, like the only one who had dancers. It was dope. Like, I was just ecstatic about being in the midst of so many people who look like ordinary people, but they actually got a lot of stuff going on. I mean, BET was in the room, Blaq Ink was in the room, we were here, you know what I'm saying? So it was definitely a dope vibe. I enjoyed it, I had a great time. That's what it was.
Niggas mad, they ain't even got the coof. Step to me, shawty, do what you do. Feeling foggy, gonna make that ass jump when you see it represent.
I'm 30 now, you guys. I'm 30. Wow. And I want to be around people who really grew up with me, who really love me, people who I know that, you know, that saw Rodney be turned into Rodney.
Take me down my Tennessee. I'm hot and dry.
And I'm sitting down with my cousin.
Cousin, I'm 30.
I know, how you feel about it.
30 years old. At first I cried. I was like, ooh, you know, I'm not in my 20s. You know, it's considered old in the gay world.
No, it's not.
That's what I'm saying. They call you old in a minute.
Oh, he too old now.
Yeah,
right.
Yes. But now, honestly, I feel like I have wisdom. Honestly, I'm happy. You know, yeah. I just feel like all the seeds I harvest, I mean, I planted in my 20s, I'm going to harvest them in my 30s. Yeah. Like,
you're going to pick them in your 40s.
And it's kind of sad that I didn't have the part that I wanted, but I wanted to be around family.
That's all I
you know, because I'm like,
my cousin is 28. She has two kids working on baby number 3. You know, like, we were little kids digging in ditches, trying to catch crawfish and tadpoles, and now my cousin's having babies and all stuff around me.
And I just want to be around people who actually love me and care about me and, you know, grew up with me and know what I'm being through. Mm-hmm. They gonna talk about my fat ass thing. Bust some high.
We gonna pop some buttons tonight.
A lot of stuff going on in there. I'm really excited. My award show coming up. I got nominee for Rising Star Media for Blaq Media Honors. Yeah, your cousin's doing things. Yay. And I'm just really ready to like get that award and win and just soar. I have my book tours coming out. I have a lot going on.
You gonna do a tour for it?
Yeah, you know what, let me tell you something. I was really, I got really depressed right before New Year's. You know how that spirit get over you, like you just like, I ain't gonna do what I want to do. Mm-hmm. And then I realized God was like, why are you right here complaining and crying when you got in Shame Magazine? He got featured in Plastic Control. I got featured in, not Forbes, what's the other thing? I can't remember. But that's a good thing, see, I forgot. But like, sometimes I have to realize and be like, you know what, God, thank you. The COVID-19 was hard, but I can honestly say, Andy, that was one of the best decisions of my media career. Like, best years of my media career.
This one was, yeah.
My book sold a lot.
You had a lot of opportunities, too. Yeah. Even though all this was going on, you did.
Yeah, God been good to me. You know, the girls don't like me in Atlanta because of
it. But it's so good to catch with my cousin, India. Andy, you know I love you so much. You are my heart. And I am so thankful to be around my family that I'm turning 30. I'm 30 years old, you guys. I'm old in gay years.
Maybe.
Okay.
Either they gonna receive it or not.
It's okay. Guess we're gonna keep rising to the top. Battle there.
You better fly. You better fly, baby.
Well, let's go ahead and get this part. I get people.
Yes,
because
I'm hungry.
I'm a little hungry.
I'm feeding for two.
Look, I'm feeding for two too. Chicken wing.
Down my Tennessee, I'm hot and dry. Don't follow me, love me twice.
First I was sad, not gonna lie, and then I was just like, because I'm not in my 20s, I feel like I'm getting old.
You kept saying you want to be 30, now you're 30.
I'm happy now.
Oh, okay.
I'm happy now. At first I wasn't mad. Because I just feel like now it's not, you know, when you're in 20s, you're looking for your 30s. Now it's like I'm 30 looking for my 40s.
Out of society. And I'm a lost boy forever young.
So Melvin, thank you so much for coming.
Yes.
It really means a lot.
Yes, Quincy told me at last minute, so you know, kind of last minute thing, but I came and I said, let me come and support Rodney. You only turned 31.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Daniels!
What's going on, man?
What's up, Daniels?
Thank you much.
Is Twister fixing me a beverage?
I don't know. I was looking at, I thought I saw you out here crying, Rodney, but you know you're crying.
I am sensitive. I'm gonna hold in till y'all do y'all speeches. And I don't go under 30. But I would say to myself, how did you feel turning 30? Were you sad?
Fuck no. I'm happy to be alive.
I was the only one who was a little bit sad.
Why you sad?
I was a little bit. I'm not in my 20s. You know, in the gang world, they call us old queens now.
I know that.
We the elders.
But hey, at the end of the day, just pray you look this good when you're 30.
Country living is really the best living there is.
I know y'all been having sex. But man, have you been having sex during
this
pandemic?
We been having sex?
I hope y'all having sex, y'all together.
Because we're happily married.
That's why I direct this question to Melvin. Melvin, have you been having, how you
feel? I have not.
You haven't?
I haven't been having sex.
Some of my friends who I grew up with from childhood, my best friend Melvin, who I grew up met in college, and Melvin's talking about his sex toys. Boy, you played with the toys? I thought you had a man's, Melvin. I thought you had a man.
I've been keeping it, you know.
For real?
Yes.
Child, by June, I was like, bust it wide open. Bust it wide open.
You know, I have a few toys, you know, I play with, you know, but other than that.
When the last time you had sex, Rodney?
And then the man was going to ask me about when the last time I had sex. None of your damn business. What, like, you don't answer that, Mel. Now, you know, what are you doing? You know, you think that's a private conversation, Mel. You know better than that. But either way it goes, I am still a virgin in 2021.
It's a new year, last year.
You haven't had sex this year?
I have not. I'm so proud of myself. 3 days in, I'm not a whore.
I did.
When was the last time you had sex, Roger? Truthfully.
Truthfully?
Yes.
Ooh, child.
You know you busted open that because.
No, I did not.
As soon as you touched that.
I will say.
So you didn't bust honestly, it down last night?
November, I didn't.
Damn.
I wanted to. I tried.
You should have busted down last night.
Take me down my Tennessee. I'm hot and dry, don't follow me. Love me twice, then run from me. Well, this boy, he needs no company. This life is sharp like Pittsburgh steel. Hot enough the dark with my piss warm.
Happy birthday.
Ain't seen it no more. Well, you're such a hero, so you haven't made it.
Thank you, Daddy.
And you know, you just keep on doing what you're doing. And if you need us, you know we on our motherfucking
way. Well, you know, in the LGBTQ community, a lot of people don't have their fathers, and I am very blessed to grow up with my mother and father. And my dad is a man of very few words, so when he speak and say something, it means so much to me. I love my dad. My dad's been there through me through it all. Even though we had disagreements when I came out as gay, he is, you know, had his little saying, I'm not gonna lie, and I said some things to him, but in the end of the day, we reconnected. That's my daddy. You know, my daddy taught me everything. What little boy don't love their dad? I love my dad so much. I love my best friend, Bunny, I've been knowing since fourth grade. If we both end up being gay, what the ironic shit is that? I love my sister Nakisha. That is like my twin, even though we're 14 years apart. We are so much alike. We are thick as thieves. I love her husband, Ronnie. And you guys, I'm tell you something. You know, I made a joke about them getting married in less than 6 months. We know it's right. And you know it's right. Know what you got to do. Because right now, they building businesses. They on their darn second home. They about to get a yacht. They doing the damn thing. So, hey, look at me. I'm still trying to figure shit out. So, hey, I'm proud of you, sis. In the day, I love my family, I love my friends. I'm so happy that I went home to celebrate my 30th birthday with people who I love and grew up with. I had a great time.
I didn't cry for nothing. But I wanted to show my parents that they raised me correctly. I can stand on my own. And when I moved away, y'all, it's hard. I'm not going to say it's not hard. But you gain some type of comfort you would never have without staying around family. And I'm thankful for everybody. Y'all taught me every life lesson because Atlanta have a lot of damn shakers and movers. But this learning from. Well, I meant backstabbers, you know.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
But I learned from each and every person in this room, and I just want to say that y'all all helped me grow and make me who I am today. And I'm just really blessed to see 30, and I thank God for this. I say I'm only, 8 years old. Well, nine, because 2012. So, wait, did I add that right?
I don't know, man. Let's just go.
You know, it's okay. Yeah. 8 years. Yeah, I did it right now. So, I just want to say, each and every, thank you all for coming, and it truly means a lot, and each of y'all, like I said, hold a very near, dear place in my heart, and I wouldn't have my birthday another way, spending my 30th.
The reason why I chose Atlanta was because we're only 6 hours away, and I have my last living grandmother that was alive. Now she has gone on to glory. She had dementia, and it's hard. I miss her a lot, but I'm really, really thankful that I was able to go home and see her when I could. My grandmother has done so much for me. There's someone who just, when I went to college and I ran up a tab, and all I had to do was call my grandparents, and they were just always there. I want to miss her, but I know that she's in a better place, and I'm just so thankful all the times I went home. Even when people ask me why I go home so much, and why you always drive to Mississippi, it's because I love my grandmother. I love my family. My family is, as you can see, everything to me. I have good friends and people who just really care about me and not judge me for things that I do, and I move myself around them, and I miss my grandma to this day, but I'm just thankful that I was able to go home and spend time with her and our Thelda P. Wash. I will always love you, and I cannot wait till we meet again.
Coming up on Set It Off Atlanta.
Now, Blaq is actually coming tonight as well.
Oh.
Let's talk about some tea.
Oh! I really think.
Wait, hold on, time flag on the head. Who was that?
What?
Carl, I don't know you, but I don't know you, but I know you.
I think I'm gonna start this, keep this video a little basic this time. Yeah. But you know, at all the traditional YouTube thing, I wanna show y'all one cool thing. So we're gonna start with this beautiful intro, right? So I'm gonna let y'all see it, and we're gonna come back. So let's try to watch this.
So I am super duper excited about buying my first home, and I decided to invite Rodney over to check it out. I can show him around.
This is nice.
It's so good to see you.
Good to see you too.
I wanted you to share this moment that I'm about to have.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Come on through. Come
now let's give you some more parking on time.
I know that part, right?
On the pavement.
I am so proud of Terrance. I think it's very, very important that a Blaq man in the community, I don't care about your if you're gay or straight, just a Blaq man owning something in his life. That is very admirable. That's something I aspire to have one day. Like, the house is gorgeous. Did y'all see it? He even got a little basement, throw little parties in the back. So, but it's so gorgeous. And I'm so proud of you, Terrance. And you, Terrance, your goals. When it comes to like a house that's goals, and I ain't gonna throw no shade at you, bro. I'm proud of you. I'm trying to get like you. So, go live up on these hoes. I'm trying to talk about a bitch, but go live up on these hoes. You getting it, bro.
It's
me. After that situation with Norris bringing up Blaq's situation and his post on social media, later on I had talked to Blaq, and then later on after that he puts in our group chat that he is stepping away from everyone. So I found that to be very like weird.
Now Blaq is actually coming tonight as well.
Oh, yeah. So wait a minute. Okay, so I'm confused because I talked to Blaq after we met the other day.
I did too. I talked to him.
And, you know, I told him my side of the story and what have you. I was like, hey, I'm all about, you know, privacy and things of that sort. I said, I just wish you up because I knew you were out of town, but I knew we still was talking to you throughout the time. So I was like, hey, anybody talking to Blaq? Make sure we keep cool, whatever. So he was like, no, it wasn't you, I knew it was, whatever. I said, well, I just want
to... Yeah, like he told me to, they said the message wasn't, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
That was private.
But then he said it, but in the conversation he said he quit. So I'm thinking, like, he quit, like, what's happening? Like, I'm done with that bullshit.
I'm not going to separate myself from someone who's being messy. If anything, I'm going to confront them one-on-one, man-to-man, adult-to-adult, and find out, like, why did you do it? What was the reasoning? And why would you do it around others when I'm not around? Like, for people to do things like messiness like that, and that person that you're talking about is not around, I feel like you're a sucker or you're a coward.
I talked to him, man. You know how you get in your feelings. Yeah. I quit before too. I can't talk about you, but I put a whole seat. But I'm mad. Right.
Exactly.
No, but yeah, but I just told him, like, you know, like, just come. Like, I know you want to have a conversation. I'm okay with that.
Right.
Like, it's okay.
Yeah, that's
and he said he would.
I can't see.
But I kind of feel bad too, because I think we have to talk to Carl at all today. Because Carl's going to be there as well. I don't want.
Oh, because you're doing your radio interview.
Hey, Mike.
Okay, right.
Oh, me and Terrance Reed came out with the shit show that happened at Enrique's, aka Papa Smurf, anniversary. And I just felt like it was just very, honestly, it was just very tacky with Norris did. There's no words to describe that. But in the day, I like Norris, honestly. I want to see Norris do better for herself. Norris had shown interest in me about what I do, and I want to help Norris be the best he can be. You know, because I see potential, and I like what he got going on.
And, you know,
we're
going to meet Carl today at the Selfie Museum, and I know Carl don't really care
for
Norris. So I was like, So I'm like, Carl, you know, let's talk about y'all issues later.
But Rodney, yeah. With this group of people, they have to be accountable for being adults. Just because if you and I have a falling out, and you so happen to be somewhere where somebody, one of the other cast members invite me, I'm man enough to still be around you. I might not say nothing to you, but I'm not going to be like, well, bitch, why the fuck did it? Because that's not the time or the place. We there.
Exactly. Most of y'all stuff, and then you got bitch.
Then afterwards, I'm like, Rodney, we need to talk.
Yeah,
like, that's I was kind of way about X, Y, and Z. Like, why did you do da 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 da? Well, if you had an issue with me about something, I'd rather have somebody come to me and tell me they have an issue with me before you go to somebody else and say, I got an issue.
Like, I
like, you know what I'm saying? That's like Norris coming to you saying he got an issue with me.
And now with this Blaq situation, and then we got Carl's situation, though we don't care for Norris. I don't want to set Norris up to something that can happen to him or him be like, backlash about what's going on, because like that's not cool, and I don't want to set nobody up. You know, I was like, shoot, should I tell Norris that people are going to be there who don't really technically care for you?
And so your party's going to be this weekend?
At my old house.
Okay.
That's going to be my last event at my old house.
Okay.
Yeah, and then I'll be closing on this one in a week.
Well, I'm really excited to see the people. Yeah. I haven't met everyone yet.
Outside of the group that's coming.
Mm.
Blaq said he was still gonna come. Who else? Norris was coming. I think Enrique's coming, I'm not sure. That's about it. I don't know. Well, I don't know if Tyrese coming or Paul's coming. Chapter in my life that I started, and I just wanted to share it because normally I don't share my personal business, but I did this time.
What's up, guys? I'm just scrolling through my email. I got an email to be an invite for a influencer for the Selfie Museum here in Atlanta. It's new, it's nice, it's beautiful. And I'm like, you know what? Let's meet this, share this good time with my good girls. So I invited Carl, who is always freaking late. And I invited Terrance.
So we're there, having a good time, and all of a sudden, I was like, is that Carl? What? Carl shows up. My goodness. So I was so glad to see Carl and catch up. I hadn't seen him in like 10 years. No, but I hadn't seen Carl in quite some time, so it was great to see him and catch up and see what he's been up to. And I think y'all gonna notice a little something in this episode. Just see if you pay attention. I'm not gonna say anything.
You know, I love Carl, don't get me wrong. I love him so much. Carl's funny, he's a good time. But he's late, and that's very unprofessional, Carl. You've been doing this long as me. You know time is precious. So please be on time next time. That's all I ask of you. No, just be on time. You ain't shipping him to check back. Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your boy K-Star. A lot of you may know me as Carl Avanzo as well. I'm an actor, a rapper. Y'all probably know me from numerous appearances in a million different shows and just from online talking shit on a regular basis. And I would like to say, you know, I am here. What's up? So my good friend Rodney has invited me down to the Selfie Museum. I didn't even know they had one of these. It's gonna be a great time to see what's in here, catch up with some old friends, find out what's been going on with everybody for one, and just, you know, take some pictures, because y'all know I hate really taking pictures, but I'm gonna really try to get into it today.
What's up? What's going on? What y'all been up to?
What's going on with you?
I see you got a new team.
I'm here with my Nene and Weekly.
What?
Let's talk about them teeth. So basically what happened was I was trying out some new teeth to get veneers, which everybody say I don't really need them, but you know, I got a gap that I'd be tired of. So I said, you know, I'm gonna take them for a spin. They had some snap-ons. I said, let me try to, you know, see what these are giving first. And you know, they were just giving real, you know, Nene Leakes horse mouth is what it was given. So, you know, I just felt like, let me talk to this with my friends and see what they think of these teeth and see if these bitches gonna lie to me.
You got the Nene Leakes.
I'm doing hair. It was on my hair.
I can't die.
He gonna be smiling for no reason.
Okay, like what you say? Hey, Christmas. Look, you know people like this.
Yeah, right. Like, you're smiling for a bitch. I just told you something drastic.
You like what?
Like, bitch, I just told you something. Like,
I am so sad.
Then we are trying to have a regular conversation, and this big ass truck come out of nowhere, scared the shit out of me. Okay, because you know I don't be needing loud noises behind me. This may be the Selfie Museum, but we still in the hood, so I'm scared naturally. But you know, we sit there talking. I'm showing them these trial teachers just to see if these bitches gonna be real or fake about it, because you know sometimes you go, you hit somebody with something, and they should be looking like, oh yeah, girl, them is real cute, my girl. These teeth don't even fit my mouth, but we gonna see who these bitches gonna lie. And of course, Rodney with her little, her fake ass, she always gonna lie. Oh yeah, girl, do it, bitch, for her lying ass. But bitch, you know what? I see her, and she know I see her.
I think about it, was it fun?
No, I love this. This is a wonderful idea. Like, for me, I just wish they had more masculine rooms. Okay, I'll tackle this one.
Because a lot of it's the pink and purples and
fur, and I'm gonna
But just some more masculinity in it. Some more, it's like maybe some earth tone.
Yeah, you know, more like a cute little brown, like
yeah,
I think. Now, Terrance, child, I know you wanted more masculine sets, but girl, you were not even masculine. What you wanted? You want a football, something going on, a basketball, something? Two things you ain't gonna do. Every time I see you got your ass out, you got a pair of panties on. I don't understand why. I think the pink rainbow and the, you know, the pink wings were just well for you. I think that just works out for you. I don't understand why you had a problem with that. I mean, so you know, some of the girls think they're more masculine than they are, and that's cute. So, I mean, if she wanted to go take something in front of the Atlanta Braves, I mean, hey, we were down the street, girl. You could have just went down there and got you a selfie in front of Mercedes-Benz Stadium if that's what you wanted to do. But right now, I'm going to take a picture in front of the fluffy pink background with the cute little phone and all the little smiley faces, because, you know, I think it's cute and I like colors.
You yeah. have little bunny pussy.
You see, you already know.
When you first said that,
I wouldn't be mad if I came in with a jock strap on.
Oh, they probably, you might have to rent it out yourself.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm like, don't nobody look at me.
Get it. But when you said Atlanta Selfie Museum,
I'm like, what the fuck?
So they brought me to CNN.
When you first said
You know how people look like, what about that bitch? Not sleep well with
yes, I want to.
And I don't know what it is.
Right, but it's something.
So what events you have coming up? The next thing I have coming up
is actually, I'm actually kind of got my schedule open right now. I actually wrote a movie, and we are going to production in April, May, I want to say.
Can I get a part?
All right.
It's already cast, and we did it months ago.
Oh my God.
I have a movie coming out that I wrote a script for. Actually, I thought, like, you know what, I should get on live, just tell everybody my story. But I said, you know what, why not just, you know, flex my writing hand? Because, you know, we all got many talents. So let me see if I can actually do this. This is really the main reason I wanted to do it. And I wanted to see if I could really put my story to paper. And I actually got the script written. It's called A Serial Lover's Entanglement. Production got held up because of COVID, a few other things going on, and you know me, I like to just do things right. So it's production is holding until we figure out exactly what we're gonna do with it, but you guys stay tuned for that. It's coming out soon. Y'all would love it. Y'all would have to see the story to actually believe that crap actually happened to me, but it's a true story that really did happen. So y'all be on the lookout for that.
Yeah, Rodney, thank you so much for inviting me.
Thank y'all for coming.
Like,
yeah.
So nice.
Yes, this was really, really nice.
Okay,
girl said you a mean ass bitch.
Who? Said he is? Oh, I was about to say. Oh my God. Am I going to see y'all Saturday? Yeah, absolutely. I'll remind everybody.
Yeah, just remind them.
Yes, I'll remind you.
All right, I'll
push
it in my calendar like I need.
Good luck on your interview.
Oh, yeah, good luck.
I'm scared. Don't be scared. Because I'll be like this.
Well, we are coming to an end of the great Selfie Museum. I was glad to see Carl new teeth. And I'm glad he got rid of them, y'all. Because I love Carl, but them teeth was not it. Whoever you paid that, whoever money you paid for that, please go get you a goddamn refund, Carl. But I do hope that you drop that money, pussy, y'all, because I love the song. I am a fan. You know, if you need somebody, come drop it for you. Call your boy.
Coming up, Knockout, on Set It Off Atlanta.
Dope show, you know.
Special guest with us today, we got Mr. Rodney Wash in the building.
Hey, Rodney!
Oh, even like, didn't get no publicists. You know, you have these publicists out here who be posing with people, like they actually working, but there's actually taking
stuff. A fan.
Like that one person that always want to come into a group and just want to be like, just want to do, they need a moment, okay?
But you're supposed to be my assistant, though.
Yeah.
Is he?
This is your assistant?
Ooh.
Your eyes on me apply. Get it, don't be timid when you in it, fight. Love up on it, live alone and leave it. Say, so I don't want no drip, baby, spray it like you need it. So fine, it's spicy, baby, jump up on it. I guess that's why you like it, baby, come and get this. Takes a lot to excite me, baby, give it all you got. I'm a tough cookie, baby, get the right side. Bobby, baby, twist it on it. Do it like you mean it, darling.
Tonight I'm at Knockout. I got booked for this dope show. You know, it's at kind of like a strip lounge type vibe. You know, it's real hood trap type stuff. It's a little different for me, but you know, your boy is here. I brought the crew out. I got my boy Antonio. I got my sister with me, and one of my girls came up from Dublin. Like, we about to turn this bitch out. They got several performers on the lineup. Like, we here. It's a dope vibe. Like, I'm feeling it. Got my little drinks in my system. Everybody trying to get me hot for some reason. I don't understand that. But, you know, we vibing out. We doing what we got to do. And your boy is lit for real. Koof is definitely the song that I'm doing tonight. Like, when I tell y'all Koof gives that trap vibe, Koof is it. And it's also a diss record a little bit. You know, I heard some stuff in the streets where people wanted to do some stuff. So I decided to write my own little record. So it's good for the people in the hood to hear, play it. I even got the DJ talk about spinning my record. So we vibing out tonight. It's going up for real.
Go ahead and make it egg. Get it, 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 get it. I need to see him get it, get it, get it, get it, get it.
All right, everybody. I know a lot of people probably know me from acting and rapping, but they don't know I started doing radio before both. I started off my own show, and things with production and some of the other cast members on my radio station just didn't work out so well. So I ended up being picked up to actually combine forces and do a show with Hey Mikey. Hey Mikey is a great friend of mine. He's always funny. He's very professional, has a lot of connections in the game. And I had my own show, but I wanted to let it go because radio just wasn't doing what I needed it to do for me, so I kind of left radio alone. But when Mikey asked me to come on to be his co-host, along with Imani Vanzap, I said, you know what? That was a no-brainer. So naturally, they decided to put me over the talent, which would be local LGBTQ talent, find out what they're going on, so all the local artists, authors, painters, book writers. That's what your boy had to do. And I said, you know what? My good homegirl with her white ass, she got a goddamn book coming out. Why not bring her ass on here and she can talk about it? Because it's like real cute. It wasn't like no, you know, the paperback books there, everybody come off with the big ass words on it. She actually had some little words on there. So I said, girl, come on, let's talk about it. So now she's here, and I said, you know, we're gonna get into some things. We're gonna get into the book, we're gonna get into what she's got going on, and you know we're gonna get into some mess and some tea and some bitches we probably do not like.
Special guest with us today, we got Mr. Rodney Wash in the building.
Hey, Rodney!
Hey. He's not kicking it with us.
Well, I have an interview with the Hey Mikey Show with Imani Vanzap and Carl. He's got the deep end. But today, you guys, I am talking about my book, My Baby. Can you see it? Media World Through My Eyes by Rodney Wash, Branding Your Brand. This book is really personal to me, you guys. I have a lot of guys reach out to me. They asked me how I built my brand. You know, it's hard. I cried a lot. I went broke trying to do this. I hurt a lot. People backstabbed me. You see, I had a brand manager in the beginning. She's no longer with me. Like, people use you for your contacts. You know, and you see people just want to be connected with you to gain something from you. And, you know, and all that rich round.
Let me see this.
What is the book about?
It's really about, like, basic media words in my eyes. Basically, like, how I started off in 2018, right, on Facebook. And from Facebook, we got picked up by this radio station. So in March, we started on Facebook. By, I want to say, June, we was on a radio station. And by September, we was picked up by Roll Now Magazine.
Okay.
So shout out to Lipstick and Cognac. They would always be my, you know, my baby.
Aww.
My book is really about what I experienced in this media industry. Teach you how to quit your 9-to-5. How to make profit off of your brand. I am so, so thankful for this interview with Hey Mikey. And it's just a good time. And Blaq came along with me. Now, like I said earlier, did Blaq really come for me or did he come for himself?
And, you know, they're starting off and, you know, being really happy, especially you start making money.
Mm.
And you just be like, oh, I'm doing it. You know, so once what I was doing started competing with my salary, my 9-to-5, I was like, I need to make a change.
Mm.
But before that, I didn't have an LLC. I didn't have an EIN number.
Mm.
I didn't have a business checking account, a business phone number, a website or email. I was based this doing it.
Rodney is on it, y'all. When I tell y'all he done invited me to another podcast, radio show, I don't know what it is, but this boy is on it.
Yeah. And so when it came time for me to file my taxes, I owed over $10,000 to IRS.
God.
And you know, even like didn't get no publicists. You know, you have these publicists out here who be posing with people like they actually working, but there's actually taking some
a fan
with people. Mm-hmm. I got swindled out of $3,000 with a person who said they can actually do something for my career. And I'll be honest with myself.
No.
I feel like I should blame myself too, because even though I was popping and doing good things, I was not where I felt like I was in my head. And he should have been real, say, you know, you're not there yet. You need to still grow.
Apparently, Norris is supposed to be there too. So I'm definitely going to see how it go. You know, play it safe or whatever like that. You know, just vibe, whatever happened, it just happens.
Yeah. Okay.
Absolutely.
Carl, any other messy question you would like to bring to the table?
Let me think. You know, I had so many brewing back here, but I just got so caught up in the moment. I'm like, girl, you starting a business, girl? You ain't got no LLC, bitch. You ain't got no EIN, girl. You just ain't got nothing going on here, girl. You need to really get your stuff together. No wonder you had to write a book, bitch. I think you needed the book for yourself. But, you know, listening to their story, I'm listening to them coming in here and they're telling me about Norris and everything that's going on with that situation. And I'm looking like, I told y'all from jump that she was a trash ass bitch. Y'all knew that. But
Norris,
did I not tell y'all that? I be telling y'all. Y'all don't never listen to me when I tell y'all shit.
Yeah.
I just told him that earlier.
He shouldn't have bought it.
I'm telling you. And then watch what Terrence said to myself. She got been through a lot. And you need to lead with that. Because you come off with the attitude. And then if I snatch you by your throat, then
who
I'm wrong.
Been through a lot, though?
Who?
Who been through a lot?
That's what Terrence said.
No, I heard his story. Now, I did sympathize. His story was kind of, it
Norris
was sad.
Norris is ignorant.
You don't think it's the way?
Norris is very ignorant. And if he been through a lot, that ain't got nothing to do with nobody on this
That's
show.
True. Now, I do agree with that. But I'm talking about, like, I kind of, like, feel like I got a like a more of a understanding behind the man. Because of what he's going through.
I get it, but my thing is you bring a lot of stuff on yourself. That has nothing to do with nobody else here. You feel what I'm saying? Like, you bought it on yourself. I'm not finna have sympathy for nobody who brought some shit on theyself.
You better speak out.
And then he real ignorant from what he did, too, so.
Yeah, I mean, that was wrong. I'm not gonna lie.
What he do? Y'all ain't tell me what
so, you know, I did my busted challenge with my dude or whatever.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. The guns.
excuse.
Dad didn't know nothing about it. Papa Smurf didn't know nothing about it. So if he would have known, I know he would have called me and asked who the boy was. So Norris took it upon himself to mention it when they were having a conversation. Recorded it. And you had a conversation about something that ain't have nothing to do with. You know, I wasn't there, so it didn't have nothing to do with what y'all was talking about.
Doesn't mean receipts these days.
Screen record has ruined many a life.
I can't.
But my question is, when you're doing things like receipts, what is your motive?
Exactly.
Why are you?
You know what? I ain't gonna lie. When he did that, I was like, Norris, what is the purpose of doing this? And Norris, and this is out of Norris' mouth, this is Norris' words. He said it's public, so what's wrong with doing it?
First off, if I post something on my Instagram, that's my life, regardless.
Yeah.
This work right here. You feel what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So my personal life ain't got nothing to do with my job. My personal life is not how I get paid. You feel what I'm saying? So therefore, why are you bringing up something that has nothing to do with you? To somebody that I ain't even told about it. If I was gonna bring up a situation about my relationship, I should have been the one to do that. Mm-hmm. It shouldn't have came out your mouth. The thing about it is, you were supposed to be here tonight, but you didn't come. I'm gonna be respectful.
Then you got Rodney sitting, her little lily white ass sitting here, and she's talking about, yeah, you're right. Oh, but he has a very sad story. Girl, whose side is you on, bitch? Is you on the side of right? Is you want to be playing this fence like you? It seems like you're doing right now. I need you to be real. Real is real. Fake is fake. You recognize the bitch was fake. You recognize all the fake shit she did, but yet you still hear someone say, oh, her story is sad. Bitch, fuck her story. If she out here doing all this extra dumb shit, I don't give a fuck how sad her story is. Like I said, the bitch should have led with that. She didn't. And when I catch her, her ass is grass. And that's just some period.
I never put my hands on him because I know what type of person he is. But I was going to let him know, keep my name out your mouth, because that had nothing to do with you. And we were supposed to be friends. You don't do stuff like that.
So, tall boy, please keep his name out your mouth.
And I say that too. And that's what kind of made me question. Yeah,
right.
Because I can see if I did it, I don't really know Blaq like that, or somebody else. But this is your good friend bringing your business to people.
Yeah.
It had nothing to, like.
Talk to y'all about
it. Was weird. I was just like, because I saw it. I liked the picture, you know? And I was just like, oh, that's cute.
I thank you because he liked it.
And I said that already.
You might
just know that one person that always want to come into a group and just want to be like, just want to do, they need a moment, okay?
But you're supposed to be my assistant, though.
Yeah.
Is he?
This is your assistant?
Ooh.
Oh, you get to fire them.
This is T.
Oh.
We had that meeting that day, and child, when she had already had jumped them eyes back, y'all know I had 3 drinks before I already got there. It took everything in me to snatch that bitch by them point-toe-ass shoes, that big-ass hat, and them tight-ass jeans she had on right where she stood at. I said, you know what?
Yeah.
And now, Blaq, child. You can bust it all day long. I don't care how many children you got, child, but you're not straight no more, okay? It's okay to be gay and have kids. I done fucked many men with children, okay? It's all right. Nobody's gonna pass you off and nobody's gonna think you a straight man. Nobody. So you might as well go ahead, get pink, get your nails done, bitch, and jump on the Bunny Pussy Remix, bitch, because we all know.
Somebody better get her. Because I'm trying. Okay, I'm definitely trying. You better get her.
All right, Rico with
a K. Well, he ain't going to LA.
Bitch, okay. Y'all know I love to keep the peace.
He says a lot.
But, bitch, I will beat her ass.
I was shocked. I was like, everybody was saying, you had more to say during the reunion than you did in the damn show. That's what I'm saying. Rico with a K came with A to the Z.
That's a hard-ass song. I mean,
he messing with my shit in here? I didn't do that.
Are we on air?
No, but okay, they just keep fucking up my goddamn show. I had a thing going here.
I am really kind of happy at the same time that Norris did not show up because, you know, it's just a lot of tension in the room and I ain't want all the energy around me. I really just want to focus on my book. So make sure y'all go buy my book. I have an audio version as well. You can Google it. I have a Google panel. That's Google Media World through my eyes and it will pop up. And I really pray that you learn from this book. I have things to write down in this book. And that's, if you are really tired, you guys, you are really tired of working for someone and you have this brain that's sitting on you, that's sitting inside of you, and you just ready for it to come out, make sure you buy this book. I promise you it will help you. It's not 1,000 pages, okay? But I do have words on mine, so I'm not trying to be shady, but, you know, let people know. I do have words on my book, and it will help you build your brand. So just remember that I told you it will help you. Thank you later.
What you need? I'm good. I'm talking about my shit is in the oven.
I got a little farther to get to tonight. So
oh, where you going? You fucking tonight, bitch?
No, bitch.
Okay, girl.
No.
Enjoy your party, bitch. Right. Not this week and a half for me.
Right. I said party, not P&P. Party.
Oh.
Yeah, I said party.
P&P.
Hold on, what's P&P?
I think that's not like Tina to me, bitch.
No, P&P is party and play. It's what the Tina girls do. I don't do none of that. Mm. I don't snort my candy and I don't smoke my meals.
Look how I walk out, y'all. Look, this is how you walk
out. No, wait. This is how you walk
out. So overall, the entire show was a success. We learned a lot about Rodney, about where he's coming from, how he got started, what a great book he has. So y'all need to make sure y'all go out and support him, even though, you know, he be lying sometimes. But anyway, y'all go out and support him. Go get Imani Vanzap, came here and did her thing. Of course, you know, if I can't ask the questions, you know, my girl always got my back. She always has to become with the questions. And of course, you got Mikey that's always gonna get into that real journalism. And you know, I'm always there for the shits. So the three of us put together, you know you're gonna have a bomb ass show. Shouts out to Rodney, he came through, did his thing, and bitch, we had a great show. So I just can't wait to see what the else is going to happen with this group of people, because child, this has been a ride, and bitch is always trying to set it off. But can they really do it?
Next time on Set It Off Atlanta.
I work, I have multiple jobs, unlike most of these girls. But the thing is,
you can't see
yourself. Keep my name out your mouth.
Okay.
You came on this situation as my assistant. You're supposed to be the closest. My flow gives you a teaser. Ask for sneak peeks, begging
for teasers. Choose this, so my nigga call me. I'm on some legendary shit, you can call me Paulo.
Yo.
Tell me what's the bus with the bus. I know a bitch popping like a pimple with no pus. I blow these bitches way like the shelf with the dust. I'm a hot topic, so you know they gon' discuss me. No way bitches can touch me. Upper echelon, but your rag D. Flea mark label, bringing nothing to the table. I'ma say the fuck again.